come. Oh, nobody, oh, ain't nobody. Do me like Jesus, he ain't my friend.
Good morning. Scripture reading will come from Psalm 105.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all the land. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him, his presence with singing. Know that he is the Lord and he is God. It is that he made us and we not ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pastures. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the God is good. His mercy is everlasting. His truth endures to the end. Thank you. Have a blessing in the reading of God's word.
Guide me. Almighty, hold me with thy providence. Thou am a weaver. Thou, Lord Almighty, heaven, feed me till I want no more. I breathe the heart of heaven. Breathe the heart of heaven. I feed me until I walk no let the fiery or cloudy pillow lead me on my journey through. I live, die, I cry. strong deliverance. Be thou still my finish here. Strong. Strong.
Let us pray. Our Father which art in heaven, Lord, we bow to the mother's dust from which we came, as humble as we know how, Lord Jesus. Thanking you again for another day, Lord Jesus, that wasn't promised to us, Lord, but we thank you for this morning's rising. Thank you for last night's laying down, Lord. And Lord, we can't go any further until we confess that, Lord, since we last bow, we've sinned against you, Lord, and sinned against one another. So, Lord, we ask for your forgiveness. We ask you to wash us with your word today, Lord. And so, Lord, we thank you so much for all the perfect gifts that come from above. We realize that we're not worthy of the least of your mercies, Lord. Thank you for your grace that brought us this far. Lord, you let our golden moments roll on just a little longer. So many have gone on, Lord, but we thank you that you've left us here. Now, Lord, put us in your perfect will, that you will get all the glory from our lives. Lord, we know that we really don't need more of you. You need more of us. So, Lord, we come to lift you today. We come to magnify you. We come to exalt your name, because there is no other name under heaven that men can be saved. So, Lord, we thank you that it is in you that we live and move and have our being. Lord, we realize we can't do nothing without you. Lord, everything you gave us, Lord, we know it comes from you. And so, Lord, we magnify you. We know, Lord, that you brought us from a mighty long way. We look back over our lives and we wonder how we got over. But we realize it was nothing but your grace, Lord, that kept us through all these years. Lord, you kept us from our early existence up to this time. And so, Lord, we're grateful. We come to say thank you today. So many times we forgot to say thank you. Thank you for food on the table, Lord Jesus. Thank you for clothes on our backs and shoes on our feet. Lord, you've been better to us than we've even been to ourselves. Lord, we thank you for our friends and family. Lord, we are so grateful that you sent your darling son, Jesus, that through him, we can have a right to the tree of life. Lord, we realize that we were dead in our sin and trespasses, but through you, we have life. Not just life, but you came that we might have life and have life more abundantly. Help us to embrace it today, Lord Jesus. Lord, we thank you for everything. Thank you for everything, Lord Jesus. We can't thank you enough if we had 10,000 tongues. So, Lord, help us be acceptable in your sight. Lord, we ask that the words of our mouth and meditation of our hearts be acceptable, Lord, unto thee, our strength and our redeemer, until you come, Lord Jesus. And Lord, we know one day we got to pack up our hymn books and Bibles. We won't be able to study one no more, Lord. We ask that you give us a home in your kingdom, and we will praise you forever for how we got over. Lord, we can't pay you, but we can say thank you for everything you brought us. We thank you for, even in the midst of calamity, how you blessed us. In the midst of destruction, how you helped us rebuild. Lord, we know that everything comes from you, Lord. So we thank you today. We bless your name in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Bless his name, bless his name, bless his name. Every praise is to our God. Every word of worship is one accord. Every praise, not just one praise, but every praise is to our God. Lord, I want to thank you for all you are. I want to thank you for all you've done. I want to praise you for being God, because you're worthy of the highest praise. Can I get a witness? He's worthy of the highest praise. Every praise is to our God. Every word of worship is what I pour. Every praise, every praise. come on, sing glory, hallelujah, every praise, every praise, oh, every praise.
Do you know he's worthy? 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 He's worthy of the glory. He's worthy of the glory. He's worthy, worthy, worthy. Every praise. Every praise. Every praise. Every praise. Every praise. Every praise. To our God, hallelujah, thank you Jesus, thank you Jesus, oh glory to God, oh glory, 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 thank you Jesus, hallelujah, thank you Jesus, thank you Jesus, woo! Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
obtain. We work and we work, but still we can't claim. But if this ain't God will for you, and you'll find this to be true, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all of these things will be added unto you. Oh, he's ready. And he's willing. He's faithful. Oh, what you need him to do. Oh, things in life, we gotta get them any way that we can. And you know that's not how God works. God has a master plan. But you gotta be faithful. You gotta be steadfast and do what you should. But those who love the Lord, can I get a witness? He'll work it out for your good. Oh, and he's ready. And he's willing. He's able
to bless the Lord today. Amen. That's good news. God is always ready, willing, and able to do what needs to be done. And I'm glad that he can do far more than man can do. Man can just go so far, but God is greater. The Bible says God is able to do more. I think that word said exceeding abundantly above all that we can ask or think.
Yes, God.
You can't even think of all that God can do for you. Amen. I don't know about you, but I'm glad to be here today. And it's good to see you here in the house of the Lord one more time. We're going to ask you, if you don't mind, to stand and join in with us for our responsive reading found on the inside of your bulletin. Responsive reading comes from the Gospel of St. Luke, 18th chapter, and verses 1 through 5. Our emphasis for the month is on prayer.
Amen.
And he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint. And there was a widow in that city, and she came unto him, saying, avenge me of mine adversary.
And he would not for a while, but afterward he said within himself, thou I fear not God, nor the Lord man.
Altogether, yet because this widow troubleth me, I will avenge her, lest by her continual coming she weary. Amen. Now, the judge helped the woman to get rid of her because she kept bothering him.
Yeah.
Now, God says, if a man like that who got power to help a woman will help her so that she'll stop worrying him.
My God.
Just imagine what God will do for you if you keep coming to him. Now, God won't help you to get rid of you, but he'll help you because he loves for you to come to it. Amen. God bless you. We are up to our announcements.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Your announcements are as follows. Thank you. Thank you for your prayers and condolences during the time of our bereavement for our beloved son, Brother Castasion Clark. We were able to draw strength from your love and support. This comes from Brother Gregory Clark and family.
Amen.
To my First Missionary Baptist Church family, thank you so much for your thoughtfulness in sending the beautiful plants and the heartfelt resolution. My family sincerely appreciates your expression of sympathy upon the death of my sister-in-law, Sister Annie B. Driver. Showers of love to each of you from Sister Ruth Shaw.
Amen.
With sincere appreciation, thank you and God bless you for supporting the Walk to End Alzheimer's. With your support, the Forget-Me-Nots team won the overall team donations of $3,240. And I won the overall captain to collect the most donations. I could not have done it without you. What we did will work in finding a cure for Alzheimer's. And once again, thank you and God bless you. From Sister Artemisia Doggett and Brother Charles Doggett.
Amen.
I'm so grateful for your thoughtfulness, your kindness, and your generous heart. Thank you. It is an awesome blessing to have the prayers and support from a loving and caring church family. We can thank you enough for all the love that was given to our family. Please keep the family lifted up unto the Lord from the Lassier and Clark family.
Amen.
Thank you. I will bless thee, and thou shalt be a blessing, from Genesis 12 and 2, to our First Missionary Baptist Church family. Through you all, God has shown his goodness. You are all a blessing to us. Thank you all so much for your prayers and kindness, for being there in our time of sorrow. May God forever bless you all. From Brother Raymond and Sister Mary Nelson.
Amen.
It is good to give thanks unto the Lord. Because of you, there's someone who is thanking God today. Someone who appreciates your warm and caring way. Someone who's remembering the special things you do and wishing you his blessings every day, the whole year through. Thanks from Sister Mary Jones and family. The City of Lufkin has job openings for various positions. If you are interested, you may pick up a copy of the vacancy from one of four bulletin boards around the church or contact the secretary's office. October 5th through the 7th at 7 p.m., Canaan Missionary Baptist Church will host their fall revival. October 9th at 7:30, the Church by Christ Jesus State Youth Department will host a musical. The youth will also host a fun day at Jones Park on Saturday, beginning at 11 a.m. October 10th at 10 a.m., the Abundant Life Ministries will host the Marvin Austin Bazaar family event. October 11th at 3 p.m., the Iron Will Missionary Baptist Church will host the appreciation service for First Lady Sister Francine Irvin. And also on that day, the County Line Baptist Church will host their annual Men and Women's Day program. We would like to say happy birthday to you for the ones who are celebrating October 4th and October the 10th. On October 4th, Sister D'Amica Jones, Brother Xavier Perkins, and Brother Tony Cole.
Amen.
October 5th, Sister Kathleen Richard and Sister Brandy Lamb. October 7th, Brother Calvin Richard, Sister Kathy Mickey, Brother Terrence Jones, and Taylor Mouse. October 8th, Reverend Webster West, Brother Timothy Hale. October 9th, Brother Danny Hartsfield, Brother Kelvin Crane. And October 10th, Sister Gloria Smith and Brother Mickey Hadnott. If we have any visitors, could you please stand and give your name and have comments if you would like? We would like to welcome you to our services this morning, and we hope that you receive a blessing on today. Thank you.
Pastor Rick's church family, I apologize. I had an announcement, but I left it on my desk. But it's a very important announcement that I want to make. Pastor Roy Allen at Mount Beulah is trying to start a savings educational achievement program for the young people in our community. And so what we're proposing is that we do a community-wide financial literacy, financial empowerment campaign. And the first meeting is going to be on Monday, October the 26th, 2015 at Mount Beulah Baptist Church at 6:00. So I'm asking you to put that on your calendar. We've got flyers that we'll be putting out in the community. The first piece, we're going to try to put a credit awareness, a credit repair program in place. We're not going to call anybody out, but if you want to have access to a program to help you improve your credit, which we know is the first step toward improving the financial well-being in our community, please be there on Monday, October the 26th. The second piece of this program is we want to start a educational savings program for the young people in our community. We're going to try to incentivize it by matching when a kid does well on his report card. We're going to give him some money and help teach him about opening a bank account. And then we're going to encourage all the parents in the community to start partnering with their children so we can start saving for the educational, post-high school education for our kids. So you'll see flyers going out. We're gonna have it on community calendar, trying to get it on TV, but I know it's only a few weeks away, October the 26th at Mount Beulah Baptist Church. I would appreciate your support. Any of your coworkers, anybody in your neighborhood that you think would benefit from this program, I would appreciate your support. And Pastor Ricks, I apologize that I forgot to bring that.
What time now?
6 o'clock. 6 o'clock, Mount Beulah, October 26th.
Amen.
Amen.
Good morning. This is your sick shut-in and bereavement report. Chicken shut-in. Dora Hollis, the aunt of Sister Carolyn Kegler and brother Larry Kegler. Tythea Jackson Edlin Rizzo White, cousin of Sister Felicia Berry. Ben Deason, uncle of brother Malcolm Deason. Ola Mae Martinez, aunt and sister of Mary Jones. Dora Swindle, sister of brother James McCoy. Bereavement. Brother Raymond Nelson and family, loss of his brother. Memorial was Monday in Houston. The family of Marcus Ford, service was held on Thursday. We ask that you continue to pray for those individuals whose name were just mentioned and those who are on the regular prayer list. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you so much. We would that we would be governed by the announcements that we have just heard. We do want to be mindful of the October 26th announcement at Mount Beulah that Brother Malcolm Deason made to us, and so we certainly want to mark that date, and so we want to be mindful of that announcement and all the other announcements that have been made. We certainly want to commend and congratulate our own Sister Artemis Doggett and her leadership in the Alzheimer's Walk. Amen. May God bless you, and we do appreciate everybody's support of Sister Doggett and this effort. Also, I want to mention that the deadline to register to vote is tomorrow, and we realize how important it is for us to be registered voters. It is a sad turnout in the black community when it comes to voting. We need more of our people to be registered to vote.
Amen.
And not only to be registered, but to go and vote. Amen. Houston, Texas has more churches perhaps than any other large city in America, but yet 2 years straight the whole city elected a lesbian mayor for the mayor of the city. And because there was only a 19% turnout among Christian voters, we need to register to vote.
Amen.
Amen. It's so important that we vote. Now, ain't no need of sitting around doing nothing, and then when somebody get in there that's not going to help us and not going to do right to our people, you want to complain. If you go vote, you can help make a difference. And let's prayerfully seek to put the right people in office. Now again, tomorrow is the deadline for us, for all who are not registered to vote. I'm registered, my family is registered, and we go vote. We go vote together. We go.
Amen.
Amen. We go vote. And now, listen. Some folk don't like to see us vote. Some folk don't like for us to vote. That ought to motivate us to be more determined to go vote. Amen. And so I certainly want to encourage us to go and register to vote. We got people like Sister Ruth Shaw and others who are here who can help you to get registered and give you all the information that's needed so that you can get registered and so that you can be a registered voter and be prepared to vote. So we certainly want to encourage you to do that. Now, on next Sunday afternoon, the Sweet Union Baptist Church
of Garrison, Texas will be having their annual Men's Day celebration. And you know, from the very beginning when they started having their Men's Day celebration, we have been their special guest. And I called Pastor Gardner here several weeks ago and told him that due to the surgery I had, that I'm not taking any engagements for the rest of the year.
Amen.
But we still, amen. We still want to be a support to Reverend Gardner and the Sweet Union Church family. From day one, when they started having their Men's Day, we have been their special guest. And just because I'm not preaching it,
amen,
I still want to support.
Amen.
You know, I'm not like them fellas. If I ain't on the preach, I ain't going. No, no, no. It's not about that. It's about being in support.
Right.
Amen. And so I certainly want to encourage us, let's be supportive of Pastor Gardner. You know, Pastor Gardner is one of the sons of our church. And we certainly want to encourage us to, let's be supportive of Pastor Gardner and the Sweet Union Church family on next Sunday. Also, I want to say thank you to our members who participated in the cleanup on yesterday. Amen. We certainly want you to know how appreciative we are for your support and your participation. This evening, if it's the Lord's will, at 6 o'clock, we want to invite everybody to come back for the Lord's Supper. Yeah. We want to have the Lord's Supper this evening at 6 o'clock. And so you don't want to miss it. We invite you to come back this evening for the taking of the Lord's Supper. Also, Tuesday is the beginning of our revival. It'll be just three nights, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. And my good friend and brother God's preacher who was with us on last year, Reverend Kevin Washington of the Concord Missionary Baptist Church, will be our evangelist. Again, we encourage everybody to come out on Tuesday night. Each night it will begin at 7 o'clock. And so we look forward to our revival services this week, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Let us prayerfully look forward to it. Also, remember that on the fourth Sunday in this month, we will have our annual Worship Day celebration.
Amen.
Amen. And the one and only, the Reverend Drayton Garner and the Sand Hill Missionary Baptist Church of Sand Hill, Texas, will be our guest. And so let us prayerfully look forward to that as well. Want to say that our own brother Larry Hackett is here. He's in the fellowship hall having worship, amen, with us, and we're glad that he's here on today. Let us remember in prayer the names that our sister mentioned on the prayer list, as well as want to add to the prayer list Sister Gracie Morrison. Sister Gracie Morrison, I understand, is not doing too good, so we want to lift her up in our prayers. Amen. And there are others that we want to remember in prayer. Some who we came in contact with this week, some who called requesting prayer, some who are really going through perhaps the toughest struggle they've had in their life. And listen, I think we mentioned last Sunday, you never know all time who's going through something.
That's right.
Amen. And so we want to lift them up in prayer. Don't take for granted just because a person look like they're all right that they're all right.
That's right.
Amen. You know, sometimes something can be going on with them that they haven't shared with anyone about. And so let's pray for each and every one. May God bless you. We are certainly glad to have our visitors with us on today. We trust that you will be blessed. Let's make ready now to give unto the Lord and to bring unto him tithes and offerings at this time. We certainly want to acknowledge the contribution of our own brother Larry Green, who has given back again to the church in way of showing his appreciation for the support that he is receiving from buying his book that he has written on prayer. And so we again are appreciative to Brother Green. Amen. Amen. May God bless you and may he keep you. As we prepare to bring tithes and offerings unto the Lord, it's a blessing indeed to have our own Reverend and Sister Brown with us. Reverend Brown is here today, and we have asked him to lead us in our offertory prayer at this time.
Good morning to my family. It's so good to be able to come to church today. Even when we are absent, First Baptist is still on our mind. Amen. In our discussion and talking about the Lord. There is so much to be said that we can say and do. And let us go to prayer. Let all eyes close, all heads bowed. This morning, O Heavenly Father,
thank you, Jesus.
We come to you just as humble as we know or have ever been taught how. We want to thank you, Father, for giving us money to give back to you. Because if it hadn't been for you, we wouldn't have any money. We wouldn't even have any peace. But oh God, you are so good. You are blessing us right now, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Continuously blessing us. And we ask that you would bless those that's going to pay their tithe and their offering today. Those that have it, those that have not. Please continue your blessings upon them that they may understand and they may be able to introduce you to somebody else that they might be able to come up with tithe and an offering. These and other blessings we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
been mighty good. Yes, he's been so good. So good, so good, so good, so good. Your blessing. Oh, oh, oh.
God bless you. Send it in this world today. Lord, we need a revival, 'cause the world has gone astray. You said if we humble ourselves, pray and seek your face, that you will forgive our sins and heal the land. Send a revival, Lord.
Send a revival.
Send a revival, Lord.
Send a revival.
Send a revival, Lord.
Send a revival in this world today.
revival in the White House.
Send a revival.
Send a revival in our schools.
Send a revival.
Send a revival in our homes.
Send a revival.
Send a revival. Send it in this world today. Lord, we need a revival, 'cause the world has gone astray. You said if we humble ourselves, pray and seek your face, that you will forgive our sins and heal the land. Send a revival in the White House.
Send a revival.
Send a revival in our schools.
Send a revival.
Send a revival in our homes.
Send a revival. Send a revival in this world.
You've got to move.
Move, Lord.
Move.
Move, Lord.
Move.
Move,
Lord.
Save,
save,
Lord.
Save,
save, Lord.
Save,
save, Lord.
Save,
save, Lord.
Jesus,
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 Jesus.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Send a revival, Lord.
Send a revival.
Send a revival, Lord.
Send a revival.
Send a revival, Lord.
Send a revival. Send a revival.
Come to praise and lift the Lord today. Y'all looking kind of dead out there. Ain't no funeral going on in here. God is yet still alive and he's in the blessed business. Can I get a witness? That's good. I said once I was satisfied in my basement, Lord, to dwell, but I didn't know why I was a prisoner in a cell. Oh yes. Oh, but now I'm dwelling on the first floor of God's love.
but I'm just here. Temporarily, and I soon shall move a bed in my Father's house and board.